Hi folks, in this video I want to demonstrate how you can test your Siemens PLC program to control a FANUC robot without actually having access to a real robot nor to a real PLC. So basically what we want to do, we want to make communicate PLC sim directly with the RoboGuide with the help of two programs. The first one will be NAT to PLC SIM, and the second one will be CapServer X. So let's start with a demonstration so that you can see that all this works. You see currently that the program AA Home is loaded, and this I would now like to change via the simulated HMI to a program called PNS0001. And to do this, I will have to choose here first the program number and then push the program select button. And you see that instantly the program has been changed. To start this program, we will first have to reset the current error that is shown, resetting, and then push a cycle start. And what you should see now is that the gripper is opening and closing because we are just calling a program called hand toggle. So let's give it a try. And you see every time I'm clicking, it's changing its state. So demonstration done. Let's go into the details, but first I will have to stop the exchange of data between RoboGuide and CapServer X. This is just to avoid that RoboGuide is freezing while we are playing around. By the way, all the explanations I will give now, you can also find them in written form following the link in the description. So obviously we would like to start with the TR portal, having a look on the program I used. The program mainly consists of two functions. A first function collecting some data from the HMI and slicing it into 3 bytes I would send over PROFINET to the real robot. And a second function reading a single byte from PROFINET and displaying status information on the HMI. To make this simulation work, you will need to do two settings in TIA. So first of all, in the properties of the PLC, you go to menu item connection mechanisms and you need to permit access with put get communication. This is to allow NAT to PLC SIM to communicate with PLC SIM. And the second setting you want to do is in the properties of the TR project. Under protection, you want to enable this option to be able to simulate functions in PLC SIM. So this being done, the next step would be that you transfer your program to PLC SIM by clicking on the PLC and downloading this to PLC SIM. I have done this already to save some time. I suppose most of you will know how to do this. What you also should do is simulate the HMI. So you click on HMI. Click on Start Simulation to show up the HMI you have seen already. So once PLC SIM is up and running, next step would be to start NAT to PLC SIM, which comes as a freeware you can find on the internet and basically consists just of an executable that you will, however, need to run as administrator for the simple reason that NAT2PLC SIM wants to stop a service using the port 102. And this will only be possible when you run it as administrator. What you will see then is this program, and you want to do these settings here. I will show you how I have done this. Stop the server, add a new line. And basically, you just need to choose two IP addresses. The first IP address is the network. You choose a network adapter through which NATO PLC SIM wants to communicate. And the easiest is for me to choose your standard Ethernet adapter. But on the internet, you will find people suggesting that you should install Microsoft Loopback adapter, which allows you to assign whatever IP address you want, even the exact same IP address you use on for your PLC in your TI project. But for me, the simplest solution seems to be to use your Ethernet adapter. So I will continue with that one, as this worked fine for me. Second IP address is the real IP address of your PLC that you have foreseen in TIA portal. So if PLC SIM is running already, you will see them here, and you can select the one that will work for you. As I'm using an S7-1500, it suggests here to choose a rack and slot 01. So I will do this too. And you would click OK. I would click Cancel, as it's already done. So all this corresponds to this line. Then you start. Don't forget to start the server. And we would then be ready to go on to CAP server X. And first thing you would like to do is to start CAP server X administration, which corresponds to this service. With a right click, you would check if the service is already running, and then move on to configuration, which will show up this window here. And there needs to be some settings done, which corresponds to these three lines and these tags. So I would show you how I have done this. So you right click on connectivity, create a new channel, choose Siemens TCP IP Ethernet, choose a name for this channel, and here is the critical point, so choose again the network adapter. And we will choose, as before, my standard Ethernet adapter, and all the other settings can remain as they are. Next step is to add a device which corresponds to your PLC. You choose a name, you choose the model of your PLC, and again, critical point, you will have to enter the IP address of the PLC. If you are working with a real PLC, you could enter here the IP address of this real PLC on your network. But as we are using NAT to PLC SIM to translate this simulation into a certain IP address, I will have to enter again the IP address of my network adapter. And all the remaining settings can again stay as they are. Okay, now we would add tags, which corresponds to the data you want to exchange with the PLC SIM. I have done this already in this part below, but I have regrouped them. This is an optional step, so you could add a new group also there, which makes it easier to observe it afterwards. So in this group, I have defined these tags, so which specify which data you want to be exchanged, so we could should compare it to our program. You see first tag, which is the command byte, and I indicated this address QB12, which I took from here. You see that I didn't put the percentage sign, which is not necessary in CAPSERVER. Second byte I'm exchanging is, that's the second byte, is QB13, which is the PNS byte corresponding to the number of the program chosen. Last one, I don't exchange the complete byte Q14. QB14, but only the first bit out of it, because RoboGuard doesn't like it if you send more data than it can actually read. So I'm extracting from QB14 only the first bit, which corresponds to the PNS strobe signal. Finally, for the return path, I'm sending back to a PLC sim a byte which contains the status information of the robot. And here we go. So this is the step where you would first like to check if the communication so far works, because we have already started. PLC sim is running. Also, our NATU PLC sim server is running. So by right-clicking on group and clicking launch quick client here, you get this window where you can observe the exchange data. And first thing you will look at is this column here, quality, which is good, which simply means that the communication is working. So if something in the chain before is not correct, so this will instantly change to bad. For example, if I stop the NATU PLC sim server, this gets bad. If I start it again, everything is up and running. So what we could do here is, yeah, we can read already the information that is sent from PLC sim to CAP server. And we have also the return information that we can modify here. So let's take a look first at our HMI. So as this is the status information, what I could do just for testing is enter 255, which is putting every bit of this byte to one. And yeah, you see that all the signalization lamps light up, which shows us that there is some communication between CAP server and PLC sim. However, in order to make this return path work, you have to make sure that in your project you have disconnected the robot from your project, and after simulating, you can reassign it here to your PLC, and you are up and running again. Okay, so it's demonstrated that the exchange between PLC sim and CAP server works. So we could now move on to RoboGuide. Closing all this, or not closing, but minimizing all this, we go to RoboGuide. And the first thing you have to do in RoboGuide is prepare your configuration of the user operator panel. So just to give you a quick idea, if you don't know this, so you go to menu, IO, UOP. You see your user operator outputs, and those need to be configured to a rack different to 48. So you can put it, for example, to 100, which corresponds to the PROFINET you would in real world like to communicate. Or for testing purposes, you could put it to 34, which corresponds to the flag register. But for the simulation, as long as it is not 48, it should work. The same you would like to do for all the user operator inputs, P18, also assign them to rack 100, for example. Then we need to do some setups to activate the user operator panel by going to system config. First of all, you want to have these lines 7, 8, 9, and 10 set to true, false, true, true. But be careful when you change line 8. Yeah, whatever change you do, I will change it back to true. You get this message here, please power on again. So you will have to restart the controller, clicking here, cycle power, to activate these changes. I won't do it as it takes too much time. And next step will be, but this is only valid. Oh no, I forgot line 42, where we have to change to remote. Once this is done, we need to change a system variable. Next, system variables. You go to remote master and you will have to set it to zero. This is mainly needed in RoboGuide because every time you restart RoboGuide or restart the controller, as we just have done, this will jump back to two and you will have to reset it to zero. Okay, so now our user operator panel is prepared. We could take a look at the setup of the exchange of data between RoboGuide and the CAP server. So we go into the cell browser, collapse everything, and go to external devices, where you want to add a new device to communicate with our OPC server, which corresponds to CAP server. You choose this CAP server and scroll down to the group we have created. Choose anonymous here and may optionally reduce here to 100 milliseconds to make the simulation a little bit more reactive. Then click OK. I will cancel again as I have done this already. Okay. And now we move to tools, external I/O connections, where again we need to configure which data we want to be exchanged. So I want to send 2 bytes and 1 bit towards the robot controller, so from CAP server to the robot controller. And read 1 byte from the robot controller to CAP server. So the important part is this column type, where you choose the tags you want to exchange. So these will, you won't have to type them, so you can choose them if the connection to CAP server works, he will show up here already the text you have defined in CAP server. Here, however, as it's return path, so we have to define where we want to read this information from, and obviously we want to take them from the user operator panel outputs, starting with the number one, a complete byte, so 8 outputs. Similar on the other side, so the information written into RoboGuide has to go into the user operator panel inputs, the first byte starting at number 1, the second byte starting at number 9, and the PNS strobe signal should be written into the UI70. Finally, there's the robot 1-2 PLC tag to be read from RoboGuide and written into the CAP server tag. Once this is done, you could connect to a CAP server, and if everything works fine, you would see that these two columns here and there should correspond perfectly. This is the confirmation that the connection works. So if everything is fine, we can check again if our connection still works. So what I will do is move the robot away from home and start another PNS program, number 3. Select it. You see changes to PNS003. What will this program do? Just return home. So I will start the program. You see that the program is running. I will hold it. The robot stops and I can restart it until the program has finished. And this is what I wanted to show you. Hope this helped and see you. Bye.